so we've had no reports of actual gunfire. It is now time for more continuing coverage. Don Lemon, CNN Tonight, picks it up right now.
Interesting to watch all those pictures coming out of Atlanta and, of course, Minneapolis, Chris. I worked in that building in Atlanta for 7 years, and it is surreal to see that happening again. I think you're right. CNN is not the news. A lot of people are being attacked. A lot of riots going on. A lot of people are losing, you know, parts of their businesses and so on. But I just think it's interesting to watch. I think it's important for people to know as well, if you're watching that, I don't know if we have a picture of what's happening in Atlanta right now, Chris, and help me get through this a little bit. I remember being there in 2007, 2008 maybe, and protesters tried to enter the building. And that's when CNN put redundancy into the building. You know, those metal gates that you see on the front of stores that roll down. So it's quite tough to get into that building. Let's hope that they don't continue to try to do that.
They weren't there tonight. They broke the glass that was right in front. And what
made that's not actually in front. The part that you saw, that was the Omni. That's near the Omni and McCormick and Smeck's restaurant. That is not the main entrance to the CNN building. And so that's where you go to the motor lobby of the hotel, and then you go out to the restaurant. The main lobby of the CNN building has those redundancies, like I said, into it. And so those gates will come down. Nobody can get in. But I think it was smart for Nick to get into a safe spot where he could report. And again, so there's Nick Valencia. Nick Valencia is now outside. Chris, I'll see you in just a little bit. As I understand, you're going to be back a little bit later on to help us with our coverage as well. There's Nick Valencia standing there now in front of the CNN Center. And this is out near Centennial Olympic Park, again, which is across the street from the Omni